This is a karmic release meditation. I've been working with karmic release for many years. Sometimes the karmic release seemed to work very well, sometimes it didn't work so well. However, I have found that working with the Egyptian divinities has made it far more powerful. Plus, I have been given various methods of clearing the energy field at a deeper level than I previously did. So, from 2004, as I taught the Isis Lotus Healing classes, many more visitors from Sirius appeared in front of me. Many more angels came to give me additional information. And the energies of Isis and the healing energies of Isis and all the divinities became far stronger. They showed many different processes to me that we could use to assist with karmic release. You will find these processes do work well. Sometimes they cause a little bit of crisis to begin with. Often divine order is human chaos. So sometimes people come to see me, they wish for karmic release, I do it. And if it's being in regard to another person, you might have an argument with that person, but the situation will clear very quickly following that. It's just sometimes when things come up to be healed, it can be a little bit of a difficult time. Sometimes everything will just fall into place instantly for people. So this will be the same for you during this karmic release on an individual level. So sitting or lying in a very comfortable place. And see the most beautiful violet pyramid above you now. Visualize it. Build it up in your mind, this violet pyramid. As you do this, the power of the pyramid is all around you. You are in the center, and all your meditations will be far stronger, far more effective. Call upon Isis, Kuan Yin, Osiris, Sekhmet, Maat, Bastet, Toth, Nuit. They all come into the room. And suddenly you're aware that you're not actually in the location where you started the meditation. You're in a very ancient temple. It's a healing temple in the center of Egypt. It is not there in physical form now. It is underneath the ground. The ruins are underneath the ground. This is not a temple that is well known. But you're in this amazing temple. It's a healing temple. That's the temple where people go when they wish to be released from difficult situations in their life. All of ancient Egypt existed spiritually, and life and religion were not separated. When you had problems in your life, you would try to deal with them with spells, incantations, meditations, going to the local priest or priestess. And this worked, and all of Egypt existed in harmony for countless thousands of years in a state of Maat or balance. And this is what we are hoping to achieve with this karmic release meditation, to release built up karma from your energy system and to bring you in a state of Maat or balance, cosmic order. Remembering you can't just have karmic releases, be released from problems you are having without giving back to others, assisting others at a later time. And you will find releasing karma far easier when you have built up a lot of good karma. This is done by assisting others in their life. Perhaps it's donating to charity, donating your time, assisting people in many, many ways. This building up of good karma, karmic credit card, makes healing of physical problems very quick for you. This building up of good karma is very important if you wish for karmic release on a regular basis, to clear situations from previous lifetimes and this lifetime, and to deal with difficult people and situations in your life. All of these can be dealt with karmic release. We all come into this world with karma from previous lifetimes embedded into us, particularly in what is called divine seed pearls in the soul star chakra, which is a little chakra sometimes called the eighth chakra or soul star chakra, just above the head. When these divine seed pearls are cleansed, cleared, activated, much karma from previous incarnations is cleared from you, so you can go on with your life without this burden of energy that you have brought in, of karmic energy from different lifetimes. Karma is not meant as a punishment. You create karma for yourself. When you die and you go through a life review process and look back at the pain and suffering you may have inflicted on others, or looked at the missed opportunities you had in one lifetime, you desire not to do this again. So you create little things to wake you up in the next incarnation. You create situations. You may come in with an illness or have an illness later in your life to learn to release it and heal yourself. You may come up against difficult people and the situation is simply that you knew each other in a previous lifetime. You never resolved situations in a previous life. It's time to resolve them now. And you can do that easily with karmic release. You may have talents waiting to be activated, but there's a blockage. Karmic release can assist with this. Many previous lifetimes, people have taken vows of poverty, abstinence during spiritual lifetimes, and these vows need to be released. Indeed, vows that couples may have taken in a past lifetime sometimes need to be released, or contracts they have made in previous lifetimes. It's an ongoing process, karmic release. And sometimes if you don't have just quite the expected result, you need to go back and fine-tune the process, the karmic release. But it does work. And it's a very powerful process once you learn to master it. So you are still at that very ancient healing temple. You are receiving lessons on the nature of karma, the nature of cosmic law and order and balance. So even if you have heard this talk before, know that on another level, many beings are around you, working with you. And whenever you do this meditation, you'll get a sense of many, many beings of light around you, working upon you. They wish to release you from this ongoing karma. It does not need to be part of you now. Seeing yourself in this ancient healing temple in Egypt that existed countless eons ago, about 10,000 years ago, before recorded history, when Egypt was at its height as a civilization, before the time we know as ancient Egypt. It was such a pure civilization, and all existed in harmony. You were sitting on the ground. Many priestesses gather around you, many priests gather around you. And there's a ceremony going on. You have been praying and fasting for many days in preparation for this releasing ceremony, this karmic release. You have had no meat. You have had just many herbal concoctions, including drinking lotus water, especially blue lotus essence. And you have been praying and fasting continuously. And now you have been granted this opportunity to release yourself from karma from past lives. Be aware now of Isis, the beautiful goddess Isis in front of you. She can change your fate in an instant. She was always known as the divine sorceress, the magician. We call upon Nefertum, spirit of the sacred lotus, to be with us. We call upon Osiris, husband of Isis, to be with us. We call upon Sekhmet, and especially we call upon Mat Toth. Toth is not only a healing god and magician and wizard as such, but also he is the keeper of the Akashic records, your soul records. He has a great scroll in his hands and he is reading it. He is looking at all your past lives, your present life, and your future incarnations. Mart is with him. She's usually depicted looking rather like Isis, but she has a feather in a headdress around her. It's a white ostrich feather of truth. In ancient Egypt, the story went that when you died and were led to the underworld by Anubis, the great protector god, you would be faced with 42 assessors and you would be judged, your soul would be judged. If your heart was heavier than a feather, you would not get into Egyptian heaven as such and would be eaten by the monsters and have a quick rebirth back onto the earth plane. So the idea is, of course, to cleanse and clear karma from you and make your soul as light as a feather, so when you are judged on judgment day, your soul will be lighter than a feather. So Mart is there with her feather. Sekhmet is there, the beautiful healing transformative goddess Sekhmet. They are lined up in front of you. The Lords of Karma are also with you. Lords of Karma, I see as angels of karma, they help you from incarnation to incarnation with what you want to do and achieve in each lifetime and what lessons you want to learn in each lifetime. Now, I'll get you to speak to Isis and just imagine that you were speaking to Isis. Thank her for her presence. And think of the problems that you've been having in your life, the situations you would like released from your life. We'll start the process with a general karmic release for problems with financial abundance. This is a common one, especially with spiritual people. They have taken vows in past lives and need to be released from those vows. So, be aware of Isis in front of you. Be aware of Mart there. And we ask Isis to please release us from all past life contracts, vows, and karma affecting us now, causing us to have a lack of abundance in our life. We ask this karmic release to be through all the layers, all the levels, all the lifetimes, and bring the release into the present time now and make it effective for all eternity. we ask for a karmic release from all situations in past lives when we have stolen for others, created situations that caused bad karma for us, and from all memories where we have been hurt or murdered when we were wealthy. And we ask for karmic release to all the levels, all the lifetimes, all aspects of time and space. And we ask this release to be brought into the present time now, effective for all eternity. Then we will ask for all karma from this lifetime in regard to money and abundance to be released immediately, please. All the layers, all the levels, and be brought into the present time now. If you have a health situation that is not resolving, it can be karma from previous incarnations. It can be a lesson you set yourself to learn in this lifetime, such as developing a major illness so you wake up to your spiritual self. Or you may have come in with a health problem. It was something you simply decided to work with in this lifetime, to still continue on a spiritual and healing path, but with this disability. So we call upon the goddess Isis, and we ask her to release us from all past life karma affecting us and our health in this incarnation. We ask this karmic to release to be through all the levels, all the lifetimes, all the situations, all the karma that has built up when we have hurt others, we have not cared for those who are sick, and all fear-based energy that we have poured into this lifetime, where we have died very painful and difficult deaths. We ask for this karma and all the energy associated with it to be released immediately through all the layers, all the levels, all the lifetimes, and be brought into the present time now. Now we'll ask for a release from all present day karma in regard to health problems, through all the present time, and to occur on all levels. If you have a major illness, it is now that you might consider asking for a contract change. This is simply saying, I no longer need this illness, this pain, the sickness and suffering in my life. I simply ask for a contract change. And Isis will grant it or not. It is best to try a simple karmic release first, then do the contract change. If it is not successful, think more about the lessons that are occurring for you, and perhaps you do not have full insight at this time. When you have full insight as to the cause of your illness or the lessons involved, then the situation will easily be resolved. In regard to people in your life, this works very well, the karmic release process. Think of someone who is causing you some problems or grief in your life. They can be personal, business, work, study related. You can even do this process with institutions, but it's simpler to do with one person. So think of the person, knowing that when the karma is released, you will find that the relationship will either improve or that person will tend to go out of your life. And we ask for karmic release between ourselves and the person that you are thinking of, through all the lives, all the levels. We ask that there's karmic release clear all past life contracts and karma between us two people immediately, please. Then ask for a karmic release from all karma that has accrued between you and the other person in this lifetime. That as much karma as is possible be released immediately, please. And the process has finished. Using the karmic release process, you can release virtually any situation out of your life. Now, you're aware of the goddess Isis in front of you. Sometimes you don't know how and why a situation is occurring in your life, and you can just call upon all your good karma and ask Isis for karmic release on the situation. It's just a matter of drawing upon your good karma, all the good things you've done in this lifetime, and asking that the situation change. So think of something that you really need a change in. See Isis in front of you. See Ma up there with her scales and her feather. See Tote there with his scroll. And simply ask Isis for this karmic release. And she will give it. Sometimes you will have a complete karmic release. Sometimes it will be to 80%. She will inform you of her decision. In regard to pain or illness, she will often give an improved condition, and sometimes she will heal the condition immediately. Thank Isis and thank all the divinities for this. Now it's time to see yourself in the future. We call upon Hamiyad, the bright white angel of miracles, to be with us now. In ancient Egypt, he was called Amun, a creator god. He appears with a big sphere of white light, like a crystal ball. He says he's going to show you your future. He holds this big crystal ball up in front of you. And it's very hazy, you can't see in it. He instructs you to visualize your life and all the situations you have mentioned as healed, and to see yourself in the future in 3 months' time with all situations healed in your life, a healed reality. So gaze in the crystal ball, and after a while you start to see yourself in the future. See yourself smiling and laughing and looking so happy. People are around you looking very joyous as well. You look very happy, very relaxed. Whatever situation was causing you sadness and grief, see it as healed. And know it will be so. If there were certain individuals that you've done a karmic release with during this meditation, see them also in the crystal ball. See yourself smiling at them. Seeing them smiling and looking quite happy. See them surrounded by many angels and helpful divinities. See them turning and walking away from you. Wish them well in their life as they walk away. If it was someone that you wanted particularly to still be in your life, just see yourself embracing that person, loving that person. Know and see the situation is healed. And now we return to the scene of Isis and Osiris and Anubis, Maat. And we thank them for these karmic releases. Isis may have some instructions for you. It may be that now you need to do something in return for these karmic releases. So listen carefully if you get a sense of you need to do something or go somewhere or give some money to someone. Whatever it is, to follow up on this. Now you're aware of many angels around you and you're aware of Isis above you. And you're aware of Metatron, the great angel Metatron, who works with your Akashic records. He's right above you and he's pouring a stream of white light down upon you. Isis is pouring a stream of white light down upon you also. And it flows down into your soul star chakra. It's a little, like a little ball of light just above your head. And as this energy flows into the soul star chakra, it spins and clears. Then the energy flows into your crown chakra, into your head and through your body. And this white light flows down into the center of your head, to the pineal gland there, into your heart, to the base chakra, down into your feet. We have little seed pearls of energy there that need to be cleansed and cleared. The process is almost complete. It's simply these little seed pearls, particularly the soul star chakra, where energy is stored from incarnation to incarnation. Now see above your head the most beautiful white lotus in place of your soul star chakra. It is the divine lotus of wisdom, and you are becoming as a lotus, reaching out for the sun. Always. The process is complete. We thank Isis, Maat, Thoth, all the ancient Egyptian divinities and angels for this karmic release.